Hey everybody, thanks for being here. This week, we're in a remote section of the Amazon Basin in Brazil, fishing for trophy peacock bass in the Jurubaji River, a tributary of the Rio Negro, of which we have exclusive access. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television.
Big fish.
Big fish. Yeah, big fish.
He's coming in easy now, but watch out. He's going to come up.
There are lots of places in Amazon where small peacock bass can be caught, but areas like this with little fishing pressure and giant fish are far and few between.
Okay, watch out. Boy's a monster.
Ooh.
Oh, they're going to net it.
Oh, it's a pig.
Yeah. Whoa. Yeah, buddy. Oh my God. Oh. Wow, he was barely hooked.
That's got to be your personal best?
Oh, yeah. Oh, this is insane. We got a lot of little butterflies so far, and you know, a bunch of other species, but we finally, yeah, barely. Oh my, he's like just skin hooked. It's just crazy. Wow, that's a Shimano Orca. It's a tuna lure, but it's just a stick bait, you know. And I wanted something that could work really fast.
16.
Yeah. Oh man, I thought
for sure it was bigger than that.
I thought I had a 20, but he's only 16, which isn't bad.
80 centimeters?
Yeah. All right, 80 centimeters. That's my best, but you've got, what, way over, you've gotten over 20, lots of them.
Right? Yeah, I've got a couple over 20.
All right, we're working on it. Wow, that just one fish was worth the trip right there. Oh my God, this is just awesome. I'll let him go now. Come on, baby. Good? Did I let him go? Mm-hmm. See you later. So what happened there is Captain said, our guide said, cast up to the point. So I wasn't sure if the point comes way out or just, you know, and then drops off here or just exactly where the point ends. You know what I mean? I'm not sure about the structure. So I just cast it all the way up, just like this. That's a big, heavy lure. So you can cast a long ways, that's good. And it's just twitching it back. And I got it all the way up. See if I can do it again. Maybe it won't come up, but I got it so it came up to the surface a little bit. And then I let it sink, and about halfway out, boom, that fish hit hard, freight train. Oh my God. So, that's what, and then our guide here says, it's not unusual to catch two in a row off of a point like this. So we're gonna keep casting off this point for a while. But that's the thing, listen to your guide. And, you know, don't come into a new area like this thinking you know everything. Because these guys are good.
A trip like this begins with a small aircraft flight out of Manaus, Brazil, the largest city in the Amazon region. From Manaus, it's about a two-hour flight up the Rio Negro River, which drains over 250,000 square miles of the vast Amazon jungle. Water which holds countless species of fish, but is particularly famous for its many species of big, hard-fighting peacock bass. We'll land at Santa Isabela, run back to the plane for things we forgot, then load up for the short ride to the mothership, which is key to the success of a trip like this. The Kalua 2 is a shallow draft liveaboard which is not only comfortable, but able to navigate the shallow sections of the smaller tributaries, giving us access to the giant peacocks. It's still morning as we head up the Rio Negro with the flat-bottom fishing boats in tow. It's several hours to our first stop at the lower end of the river, giving us time to rig up and get ready for an afternoon of fishing. We'll pass by several native villages and navigate over very shallow water, which the Kluwa 2, along with a support boat for staff, is designed to handle. Several miles up the Jurubaji, signs of civilization cease to exist, and the fishing boats are made ready for our first afternoon of fishing. The aluminum John boats are fast and stable, allowing us to cover lots of great water every day. The mothership will continue to move upstream, so every day we'll be fishing new and even more remote waters in search of giant peacock bass, or whatever else might bite.
Arowana. Nice little arrow. Oh! There he goes. That was a nice little arowana.
Welcome back to Brazil. I'm Justin Wolf. We've flown several hundred miles from Manaus to a tributary of the 1,400-mile-long Rio Negro River.
This is the area we'll be fishing one of these tributaries.
We've come to this location because that's where the big fish are.
All right, didn't take Steve long. Real subtle little lure he was using. He was just telling me that here in this part, the Amazon, they like single-bladed rippers, but this wasn't a ripper. What were we using?
We're using a zada-zada, a Brazilian bait, like a jumping minnow. Ooh. You all right?
I'm all right. That's why you should always wear sunglasses, even when sun's not shining. That lure hit me right in the nose. I got lucky I didn't get hooked. Yeah, am I bleeding? So we got a little rain today. So Steve, what about the rain? Is that good or bad for the fishing?
It's not a heavy rain. This is a light rain, so the water won't go up too much, but we need new water here. So the rain will bring it, and they call it fresh water. And then the fish will normally bite good in about a couple days. Yeah, so we've got time.
All right. That's another way of saying the fishing might be a little slow today. So we came into this lagoon. And this is where the big fish are. Now, Steve, yesterday, is this where you got both your big fish?
Yeah.
Yeah, I got two over 20 pounds in here. This isn't over 20 pounds, but it looks like a nice fish. Dude. I don't know. Who knows? You know, that's a three bar. That's not a butterfly. That's the bigger species.
Azul. Oh.
I see you made a little switch on your lure. Just explain what you did there.
Yeah, since you're working the top water, I decided to fish some mid-water baits. You know, these fish are sitting on beds in the middle of the lagoons. So this was our success yesterday, so went back to that. No, about 13.
I can't imagine. They caught them here, 27 pounds?
26 and a 27 pound fish.
I can't even, that's amazing. That they get that big and how powerful they must be. Pretty cool.
Come on, baby.
morning.
Not quite 20 pounds maybe, but that's a nice one. So the guy, he made me, asked me to switch over to a jig back here in the back of this lagoon, and the fish responded, and you could see the little babies kind of, you know, doing their little dimpling thing on the surface, and we just started kind of blind casting. I didn't cast towards anything really, and but I could tell the guy had a lot of confidence in this spot right here, so we got a good one.
Oh man, all right. But you know what? There's a lot bigger fish. It's hard to believe there is, but we're gonna keep fishing. And I think, you know, because we're in an area, you go to a lot of places in the Amazon, this is a giant one. You know, there's not everywhere you can go and you catch fish like this and expect to catch bigger. But we're in a spot here that it's kind of unique. And, you know, you notice there's nobody else around, and that's a big deal.
All right, so here's what that fish came on. This is a peacock style jig that I got from Steve last time I was here. This is, you know, I think he sold it to me for $5, right? So it's only a single hook, but it's got this extra little tail here, and you kind of twitch it and make it swim like a fish. But that's what the guide wanted to use. We were trying top water, big, you know, midwater baits, but back in here he said, okay, let's go real, you know, light and subtle. And that's what worked. So jigs are very effective for sure. So I've got Poochie Snap on there, 50 pound mono leader. And this is just 30 pound P-line XTCB braid, which is really good stuff. So, you know, if that breaks, then probably I did something wrong.
Welcome back to the Amazon Basin. I'm Justin Wolf. We're throwing topwater lures, jigs, and various subsurface stick baits in search of giant 3-bar peacock bass, like this one, landed by Scott Nelson. It's hard to believe that fish twice this size live in these waters, but of course, because it's the Amazon, you really don't know what kind of fish will hit your lure next.
Oh, it's a Strubi. That's a surprise. That's a surprise.
First stop of the morning. Woo! Look at that. They are cool.
That is a cool little, look at the paint job on these things. Oh, you hear that? He's talking to you. That's what they call them, shovel nose catfish.
And they get a whole lot bigger than that.
Okay, come on. Come back. There he is. There he is. Come on. There he is. Oh, he's just a little. What is it?
La wolf. Traíra.
Traíra. That's a wolf fish. So in those little channels right there, that's where those guys like to hang out. But so do peacocks. So you gotta shoot for the channel. Oh, come on. That is the smallest cuda in the Amazon. There, kind of a cool looking little fish. There's all these, you know, I mean, there's dolphins around here and stingrays and all kinds of stuff, because the whole Amazon basin used to tilt the other direction, right? When the Handies came up, it shifted which way the water flowed, and so all these saltwater fish got trapped in here. That's kind of the basic idea, I think. So the whole continent kind of shifted. And that's why you got this big basin like this. So it's a super unique place in the world because of the geology of it. I'll try to put the camera underwater so you can see, but you guys that do aquariums, you know, the neon tetras, right? Well, here they are in the wild. There's a whole bunch of neon tetras. It was a 2.5 hour ride back up to the boat, because the boat went upstream from where we stopped. And that's kind of the cool thing about this operation, is the boat keeps moving. It's not the same bill every time, every day. And we stopped in this place to fish, and there are macaws everywhere, and other parrots, lots of birds. This is so cool. Steve's taking some pictures of my
camera here. Hopefully we get some decent pictures. About 2.5 hours I've been taking pictures. If you like to take pictures, this is the place to come. This is awesome.
Oh, come on.
Big butterfly, though, man. Big butterfly. Holy smokes.
Right there is a very big butterfly. The world record's only 12 and a half pounds.
Yeah.
That is a very big borpoleta.
Oh, boy.
Hey, smash that bait, too.
Holy smokes. Yeah, that... I'm glad I threw up into the wood.
Yeah, wow. That is above average size. I'm guessing 6, 7?
He's 7.
Yeah.
7 pounds, yeah, that's a...
That's huge.
I just think about when I was a little kid, this was like what I wanted to do was come to the Amazon, you know, and see all the birds and the monkeys. We even saw a monkey a couple of days ago. And, you know, that's what I really liked about Guyana, which is another one of Steve's trips. That, I mean, you want to just a mind-blowing experience, you go to Guyana. But the birds and the wildlife we've seen up here, you know, so remote and so, you know, out there, that really, because I've been to the Amazon before a couple years ago, and I didn't see anything like we've seen on this trip. This trip is just mind-blowing, but hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of macaws and all kinds of really cool stuff. It's kind of like a little childhood dream come true. Come on, fish. Okay. Yeah, they're like cookie cutter 16. I don't know if this is the biggest one I got. Yeah, it's pretty close. I don't know. It's pretty darn close. Look at the bright red colors. Oh my gosh. Look at the eyeball. The eyeball is just crud.
Welcome back to the Juabaji River. I'm Justin Wolf. We're fishing off the Kalua 2, giving us access to the craziest, most remote waters you can imagine. Where you might not think there's water, there is. And it's likely to hold giant fish. The Kalua 2 staff serves up some great meals, and the boat provides all of the basic comforts of home and comfortable air-conditioned sleeping quarters. While on this trip, you should do some sightseeing in Manaus. There's a long list of things to see and do, but the world's largest fish market is definitely worth the visit. And no one can deny that feeding the arapaima is a whole lot of fun.
Oh, boy. Over here. We missed it. Oh, boys, did you see a load of that?
Steve Yatomi and Adventure Travel Alliance will arrange for city tours of your liking, and they're well worth doing. And of course, nobody can swim with the pink dolphins without smiling. The same sort of smile that giant peacocks will bring to your face. Topwater blow-ups by giant fish are often ferocious, but not always. This fish hit very subtly, but turned out to be a good one.
Oh, it's a tank. Oh my god. Here we go. Oh, whoa. Yeah. Look at him. Woo! Oh my god. They're just so incredible. The bright color. See the sun? Got the sun on that bread. It's just amazing. What did I say? 6 fish? All within like 5 centimeters of each other. And cookie cutter giant fish. Okay, it's like, I don't know, late in the afternoon, middle of the afternoon, and it is hot. The air temperature is 102. And according to the fish hawk here, the surface temperature is 95.2. But we're still gonna be fishing hard here. So, you know, it's one thing, you wanna kind of be in some shape, you know what I mean? Maybe work out a little bit before you come and make sure you can handle the heat, because there's no breeze when the sun comes out in the afternoon. Oh boy. When the cloud cover's in, it's pretty nice, but both bite has slowed down for sure. This stuff works everywhere else. I'm gonna put some on, procure anchovy, why not? Anything to get these fish to go.
Yeah, we're getting close.
One hook. Uh-oh. All right, nice and easy. Nice and easy. Yeah, I'm not pulling on them. You know, like Big Dave says, you don't fight a fish, you trick a fish. So we're just bringing them in. Whoa, he just saw me.
Oh,
I'll eat you.
Okay, yeah. Okay. Alright, here it comes. Here it comes. Come on.
One timer. Yeah.
Alright. Nice. Oh, I'm gonna get these guys a Beckman, man. We need a bigger net. Man, this is blowing me away. I know. I've caught a lot of fish a lot of different places. But I'm no expert peacock bass fisherman, you know. I mean, I'm just throwing lures and listening to the guide, and this is so much fun.
You definitely got the hot hand this trip, man, that's for sure.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, what is that? That's eight fish over whatever.
In the teens. Oh. Yeah, that might be your 20.
You think?
Yeah, that looks like it's pulling deep into there.
20 pounds.
Oh my gosh, a 20 pounder.
On
oh
video.
My god. Woo!
Oh, that is.
There he is, 20 pounder. Okay, I got careful. I don't have my fingers in his gills. I'm pinching right under his chin. And
that is a donkey.
In his gills, and oh my gosh. Wow, yeah, I can tell. He's heavy. Oh my gosh. Okay, let's get him.
Measure him.
Oh my gosh, we gotta measure him. Okay.
This gentleman here, I think he's a biologist of some sort, but he's taking notes and measurements and everything. He's done on different boats the whole trip.
Oh, we can touch 82 right there, see? Woo, let's get him back in the water. Okay, come on, baby.
Still got some spunk in him. That's a fat fish, man.
Okay, come on, baby. Hell yeah. There he is. Oh, unbelievable. I was hoping to just catch one or two big ones, you know, and maybe get a 20. Oh, that's eight fish over 15 pounds and a 20 pounder. And that 20 pound mark in peacock bass world is kind of the deal, you know, once in a lifetime kind of thing. Wow. Hey everybody, thanks for watching today's episode. And be sure to stop by the Angler West store in Woodland, Washington. I'm sure we can help you catch more fish. And remember, without the sponsors, there is no show. So please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.